So what is cryptocurrency mining? How does it all work? What is actually going on? Why do we need these DAF machines? This is a quick little video just to give you the really basic overview of what's going on and why it's so important. Quite simply, the process of cryptocurrency mining is actually not that complicated. There's many different buzzwords that you might have heard, you know, from blockchain to hash power to kind of pools and all these different types of things. But ultimately, it comes down to really quite a simple thing. We like to use, you know, some metaphors to kind of explain this to maybe make the language a little bit easier. So people think the idea of having a machine that just sits there earning you money every day is a completely crazy concept. How is that even a real thing? Surely that can't exist. Well, if you think about it the other way around, actually people have been doing this for 20 years. So say you own a website and every month you're very familiar with paying a monthly web hosting fee. Now, what are you actually paying for when you pay that monthly fee? You're paying someone who owns a physical computer server somewhere in a massive warehouse in another country, most likely. And ultimately, that computer spins away, does its thing, and it keeps your website online and keeps all the data moving through your website. So whoever owns that physical machine receives a payment from you every single month. Quite straightforward. So similarly, that's kind of what happens in the cryptocurrency space. You need a physical computer, a blockchain server, or a mining rig. And effectively what that does is it crunches lots of numbers, and all the transactions that are moving between different wallets and different addresses when all these coins are moving around, they effectively need to be checked to make sure they're real and the wallets match up and everything is good. This works on a system called a ledger, or what we know to be a blockchain ledger. So effectively, it's just like a posh spreadsheet. So if I were to send you some coins, they'd move from my address to your address, and that kind of posh spreadsheet would get stamped as an authoritative transaction from the computer processing power, from the machines, and effectively the machines would then receive a payment, a thank you, for providing that service. The machines kind of become the authority. They say, yes, this transaction to this transaction was good, we're happy with that, that's not a problem. They stamp that spreadsheet, the blockchain, the ledger for everyone to see. So by proof of work, which is where this POW things come from, proof of work, effectively crunching the numbers is the computational work that's needed. You're able to have a machine that runs 24 hours a day, crunching lots of complex maths, but it's actually providing a service for the company in which it's providing power to. So it's really not that complicated. You get paid a service fee for providing a service through this blockchain network. And ultimately, that's how we're able to make money from these machines, as these tokens that we get obviously have a marketable value, somewhat similar to maybe how the share market would work. If you want to really break it down in a very kind of common to understand example, it's slightly technically different, but a little bit like, for the sake of explanation, if you had a very powerful computer, you rented that power to Amazon. Instead of Amazon paying you for that service in pounds and pence, they would pay you in Amazon shares. Those shares, of course, have a saleable price on the market, and that subsequently is what you could sell to make money. That's exactly the same model that the blockchain equipment takes, the cryptocurrency mining rigs take. It's simply just different companies in a slightly different technological sector, but the practicalities are exactly the same. Plug it in, turn it on, leave it running, and get paid every day for helping upkeep the blockchain.